Number 10, add provisions to allow absentee voting on precinct caucus preference ballots subject to approval of voting rules by the State Central Committee.
Mr. Chair, Rick Varco, Senate District 64. I move to strike Section 10, which allows for the option of presidential preference or for absentee ballots in the presidential preference ballot.
Is there a second to the motion to amend?
Second.
The motion to amend has been seconded, the motion that is to strike Section 10. We're now going to have debate on the motion to strike Section 10. And I recognize the gentleman at microphone number 2.
Rick Varco, Senate District 64. I'll be quick because I know we all want to get on with the convention. I'm against this section for 3 reasons. One, I don't believe the Central Committee can come up with any mechanism that will genuinely prevent people from printing out a stack of absentee ballots, submitting them, and getting improper votes for a candidate. Two, I think it's entirely too complicated for our precinct conveners. We're going to have radically different treatment of absentee ballots from precinct to precinct, which will put our national delegation at risk. And third, I think it's wrong in principle. We are a caucus state. If we want to be a primary state, we should adopt a primary. You should show up in person to cast a ballot on caucus night. Thank you.
The delegate at microphone number 1.
Chuck Repke, Senate District 65. I agree with the person who made the amendment. You are opening yourself up for absolute insanity at the caucus level. The potential exists for someone from the Citizens United type to pack our caucuses with bought and paid for ballots. Absolutely guarantee destroying the caucus process. There is no way to protect that, folks, because we allow anyone to attend the caucus. We would therefore also have to amend any absentee ballot to attend the caucus, no matter which Koch brother paid for it.
My name is Pat Kelly Hall. I'm a CD4 alternate to the State Constitution Commission. I understand the concerns people have about fraud, but let's not disqualify good Democrats from participation because bad people want to take over our process. Let's instead decide we're going to police our process and train our precinct captains to do the job. Thank you.
The rules that you have adopted specify that in debates there will be up to three speeches for and 3 speeches against. We have reached that limit. So I'm going to call the question. All in favor of striking Section 10 of the Constitution Committee's Commission's report, please signify by saying aye. All opposed to striking Section 10, please signify by saying nay. The ayes have it and Section 10 is stricken.